Hello, my name is Kim Sauer, Electronica 2014 in Munich. I'm joined today by Kamran, Iqbal from Nikon. Kamran, good to see you. I saw you early this year at SMT in Nuremberg, and we spoke about some of the X-ray products that you had. Nano focus is what we were talking about then. So just let's go back to then, a little bit of a background to that, and what are the developments from that since SMT?
Absolutely, yeah. So Electronica 2014, and you're right, we did meet in SMT, and we did talk about our latest system at the time, the XDV 116 nanofocus platform. So just to give you a little bit of background about Nikon and Nikon metrology and what we do, Nikon metrology specializes in a range of inspection platforms for various industries, particularly for what we're representing for this particular week for Electronica, is our electronics specialist inspection systems. And the nanofocus, of course, falls inside that umbrella. We also have one other system, our updated XDV 160 nanofocus. It has a new look and feel, and an upgraded human interface panel as well for the operators. So it has an upgraded look, and a feel, and capability.
So that's an upgrade since we last spoke.
That's right.
To it. Okay,
that's
so right. What is that upgrade? What does it actually do?
So there's two forms of the upgrade. New software driving it, and of course a new, let's just say, the user interface panel has changed, the control systems have changed. Mm-hmm. So this makes an increased and improved operator comfort experience.
Okay, so it's much easier for the operator to navigate the system, I suppose, in that sense.
It just makes life a lot more easier when it comes to live inspection.
And I guess that's something that you're continuously looking at. How can you make life of the operator easier and upgrade the system?
Absolutely. It's a big driver in the industry at the moment as well, is health and safety awareness. Mm-hmm. And making sure the operators who do use the systems extensively, making sure they're comfortable as possible over prolonged periods of time.
Do you find that that's geography based, a requirement for like European countries more so than other countries in the world, or is it really becoming a global requirement?
It's a good question. The industry drivers have always been Europe and US, but now countries in Far East and Asia countries, especially manufacturers, they have a global presence, and they like to maintain a high standard globally. So we find ourselves actually catering to these clients who are asking a high level of expectation.
Yeah. And I suppose your customer base is global, so if you're going to be developing it for a European customer, well, you might as well make it for everyone.
Absolutely.
So that's an upgrade on that system. Are there any new software solutions or even hardware solutions that you're highlighting here at the show?
Absolutely, yeah. We are launching three new software interface and capabilities.
Gosh, you've been busy.
Yeah, very busy, very busy indeed, and very exciting as well. So I'll talk you through them. First of all, we are launching our C-Clear. C-Clear is basically a live imaging engine. And what I mean by that is actually it enables users to have the best possible image in real time or live mode. So it actually performs or enhances the image by noise reduction, filtering, averaging, and giving you the best possible image real time. So that what that means in application wise and real time performance is any operator can actually perform and actually make good judgments or good judgments with confidence about potential defects or possible defects. And of course, that means high throughput and less training requirements for the operator, because the best possible image is produced for the operator automatically.
So best quality image, what do you mean by that? Is that in terms of pixels, in terms of clarity, quality, or the three dimensions?
Absolutely,
or
what, very good question.
All of that?
Yeah, it's a combination. That's contrast, that's brightness, that's sharpness, noise reduction. Mm-hmm. So all these mean, all these elements put together give a really good X-ray image, 2D or 3D, and by that the operator can actually perform or have a good judgment of a potential defect.
Okay, and you mentioned that's targeted at specific industries that are using it, or is it something that's now coming for every industry?
The key driver for this industry were the Far East Asia, the high volume manufacturer, the PCBA, the wafer level and component level guys. And of course, like you said, our customers are global. So we make something for one sector. We, of course, like to provide that throughout all our sectors. So it's available in Europe, and that's what we're launching here first, and of course US and Asia as well. So, but the key driver was high volume, high throughput industries.
Yeah, which of course in Europe is it's more focused, it's more high mix, low volume.
That's right.
First question is, are you seeing a change of that type of manufacturing? Because some people are saying there's some manufacturing, even high volume, coming back into Europe.
That's a good question, yeah.
Or do you still find that's the traditional way of manufacturing in Europe?
It's absolutely really good. You touched it on the pulse right there. Some manufacturing, high quality manufacturers coming back, because a lot of European and Western companies and organizations, they want to have that closer link to the production environment and production links. So they're coming back to North Africa, East Europe, Central Europe as well, and of course back to the US as well. So it's coming back slowly. And it's the high-end, high-production, high-volume, automotive, high-end performance, such as some tablet computers, PCs, and that kind of thing.
And therefore, I guess, the importance of being here present at electronica is high up on your priority list.
Absolutely.
to showcase what you've got. So how's it going?
Very good. So far, so good. A lot of interest in our systems. A lot of interest in our new software features, C-Clear. The second feature I'll talk about is our BGA device analysis tool. And what this is an automated device analysis tool. So we all know bulk grid arrays. Back in the day, they were very simple arrays, but nowadays they're getting very complex. They're becoming multi-tiered 3D stack packages. And of course, when it comes to live inspection, which operators are inspecting these in live mode, they become very difficult to analyze potential defects because you're looking at multiple layers of the devices. So we've introduced what we call an automated BGA device analysis tool. It's got a couple of key components. First of all, we have a graphical interface that allows the user to create a CAD representation of the device. We have another option to actually have CAD imports. So actually an operator can import a model so they don't have to create it themselves. And then from then on, the system automates the inspection process, providing the highest resolution, highest magnification, and automates the inspection for voiding analysis, total void analysis percentages, which is very important. Any failures such as missing shorts, bridges, so this is of course, and of course measurements such as diameter, circumference, etc. So this is getting very, very important. And the key driving force behind this is it's all in our pockets. It's for phones, it's tablets, smartphones. They have higher counts in memory, and memory devices are all BGA formats so far. And they're getting very interesting now and very complex as we demand more memory in our phones and our tablets.
Yes, so, and it's growing.
Absolutely.
I mean, it's sometimes your mind boggles as to how far can it go. So finally, one of the big keywords in Germany is Industry 4.0. In other countries, they just ignore it, but it's maybe termed something else. Big data is in that mix of buzzwords, the internet of everything, those sort of things. But we're in Germany, so Industry 4.0 is all about smart factory and traceability, or that inspection element is a very big part of
Absolutely.
That. How, just to wrap this up, do your solutions convey that message on a factory-wide level to sort of grow into that Industry 4.0 smart factory system?
I would say we have a particular software feature launched for this, and we'll talk about this. It's all about catching failures earlier. It's having that confidence and that level to actually use systems at the back end and start pushing them towards the front end inspection. Because the quicker you catch a fault, the less money it's going to cost you, the less material waste and less labor waste you're going to have. So it's that kind of due diligence that our operators and our customers need to show. And our systems enable this through our software integration, our factory host integration, and making sure that we can provide traceability in the data throughout the process. And talking about traceability and defect analysis, we've just launched at the show this week our latest laminography or oblique CT style inspection called Extract. This is very, very exciting for us, and it's very exciting in terms of what it's capable of doing and performing. It enables CT style inspection, or 3D style inspection, of large boards, or larger boards, wafer level, PCB assembly, and component level. Traditionally, to perform high resolution, high magnification CT modeling, you'd actually have to cut up a sample or isolate a particular sample in a wafer or a board, and to get close as possible to the X-ray source to perform 360 degree rotation. Of course, it's never attractive to cut a board because it's time and money and labor and expenses. Yeah. So we've enabled a particular feature and capability where we can actually get the same level of modeling and resolution and magnification, and sometimes higher resolution and magnification, without actually isolating or cutting a board or a wafer or a component. Mm. So this is utilizing our XTV160 and our XTV160 nanofocus system. Mm. So it's a common feature through our software. And we're launching it here, of course, Electronica this week. So
I'm sure that'll be one of those systems that will have a lot of attraction and people and interest from people visiting your stand. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Probably see you at Apex. Definitely see you next year at Productronica and SMT, you know, at the beginning of the year. Yeah. Lovely seeing you, and best of luck for the rest of the
show.
Thank you.